Hey everyone, this is Ronak back with another video, and this is the second video in the machine learning playlist. So what we covered last tutorial was, so what all things you can expect from this playlist. So you came to know that in this playlist you are going to learn about the basics of the machine learning, to get started with the machine learning and everything, and then we learn the types of the machine learning, so the three types of supervised, unsupervised and reinforcement. If you don't know about these things, please go to the video, okay, and watch it. It is the first video in my playlist of machine learning playlist. Now today we will be covering the major difference between the classification and regression. Now these are the two terms that you come across all the time, okay. So classification in machine learning and statistics, classification is the problem of identifying to which of a set of categories a new observation belongs on the basis of the training set of the data containing observation whose category membership is known. Now definitely quite intimidating definition, I would say, for a beginner, but I'll try to break this down. If you just Google the term classification, you'll come across this thing. So what is classification in the normal dictionary? Is the action or process of classifying something. So the classification of disease according to the symptoms, that is the statement where we use the word classification. So classification is identifying something, classify a particular thing that come up, that you know, you see in the biological term it says the arrangement of the animals and the plants in the taxonomic groups according to their observed similarities. So like terrestrial and aquatic animals, you basically classify that a particular animal, and an elephant, a camel, those are the terrestrial animals. Aquatic animals are whale, shark and everything. Alright. A category into which something is put. So that is the basic definition of the word classification. So the best way to remember this thing is you see something and you name it. Okay, you classify something. Now like you see an extremely tall person, the tall person comes in front of you, you say that is a tall person. So you basically classify that the composition of the particular human that you are seeing, it's tall, and then you're classifying that particular person as a tall. Now note, the biggest thing that I want to emphasize on this one especially, classification is discrete. Now, why discrete? So why am I actually emphasizing much more on the discrete word? See, a dog can be dog, like just a dog, okay. It cannot be a little bit of dog or too much of a dog, okay. It can be like, basically a dog cannot be defined in the decimal terms. I would say why, because you see a dog, like it is a dog, it comes in front of you, you just classify that the particular animal is a dog. So if two animals are there, one of them is a cat and one of them is dog, one cannot be measured in a particular amount of percentage that okay, this animal looks like a dog. Okay, you just look at a dog and you think of the features of the dog, and then you classify that okay, this is a dog. So it is discrete, okay, it is either cat or either dog. 0, 1, true, false, yes, no. Is it a dog? Dog comes in front of you, yes. Your problem is assuming that the particular animal is a dog, and a cat comes in front of you, you say no. So 0, no, false, okay. So it is discrete, it is completely discrete, 0, 1, and it can be many classes. So if you are let's say predicting 10 animals, I would say, so 10 animals might be elephant, camel, tiger, eagle and whatnot. So all of those are discrete, okay. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Now the next term you have come across is regression. So regression is a statistical measure used in finance, investing and other disciplines that attempts to determine the strength of the relationship between one dependent variable and a series of other changing variables. Definitely quite intimidating definition, but we'll just break this down. The most easy thing, or the easy way I explain this to people, is predicting values that are continuous. Why continuous? See, why am I really emphasizing on this word, like the predicting discrete and predicting continuous? Because these are the continuous values. So assume example of predicting weight of the person based on their height. So a tall person is definitely going to weigh more than a short person. Definitely, if the short person has higher composition of body fat or muscle in his or her body, definitely they are going to weigh more. But we just take a generalized example of overall population. So well, the weight is a quantity that never can be discrete. Definitely, you know, like someone might weigh 192.34 lbs, someone might weigh 173.21 lbs, and many more. Like these numbers are endless, I would say. You can also use this in predicting the stocks. So the adjacent close and the close of the other day is obviously discrete. Then another example I would say is Bitcoin prediction. So basically you predict the Bitcoin. If you predict the Bitcoin value, that is a continuous. But if you predict that if your Bitcoin is going to fall or rise, like it is yes and no, then it is a classification algorithm. So you need to understand the difference between the two, the classification and regression. So that is why I emphasized on the words discrete and continuous. So if I am predicting the temperature of a particular day, that is definitely a regression problem. Like that is prediction of continuous values, like that. And if I am going to predict that if it is weather going to rain tomorrow, no. So it is yes and no, 0, 1, true, false. So it is classification, that is discrete. So revision of the thing. So classification involves the prediction of discrete values. Regression involves the prediction of continuous values. In the next video, you will be learning your first machine learning algorithm. Now, I won't keep you anymore in suspense, but it is going to be linear regression. That is the first machine learning algorithm that I'm going to cover in depth. So first you will learn the mathematical concept behind it, then we will implement the stuff, and then we will try to learn some or the other things with which the algorithm can be improved. Okay. So till then, stay tuned with my playlist. And if you want to learn Python, you can check out my channel. If you want to learn Python web development, you can also check out my channel. And till then, thank you for watching. Goodbye.